Okay, so we are going to talk about female reproductive system. Female reproductive system. So as we already discussed that the reproductive system is the only system where the male and the female reproductive systems are different. That means the organ associated are different. Whereas in other system like circulatory system, excretory system, nervous system, okay, muscular system, all are common irrespective of male and female. That means irrespective of genders. Whereas reproductive system is the only system where we have different organs. Okay, so today we are going to talk about female reproductive system. So before that, we will have a revision for male reproductive system. As for example, in male reproductive system, what are the different parts associated? Number one was testes. Testes, okay, which produce the sperm. Number two, vas deferens, okay, the duct, okay, the duct means which is the linkage between testes and urethra. Urethra, okay, where it is mixed with seminal vesicle, okay, seminal vesicle, a fluid is generated in seminal vesicle, okay, and it get mixed with sperm, and that is called semen. And at last we have penis. Okay, we have penis. So we talked about male reproductive system. Now we will talk about female reproductive system. So as in male, female also have different types of system. That means different organs. Number one, ovaries. Number one is ovaries. So as in case of testes, which produce, which release, or its function is to produce sperm. In the same way, ovaries produce what? Ovum or egg. Okay, so only the term has been different. Okay, that means testes in case of males, which release sperm or which produce sperm. Ovaries, they produce ovum or egg. Okay, and as we know, testes was surrounded by a scrotum and it is located outside the body, whereas ovaries, they are inside the female body. Okay, they are not located outside, they are located inside the female body. That means we have, sorry, female have two ovaries, as in case of testes also. Testes was also two in number, ovaries also are in two in number, but it is situated in the abdominal cavity. It is situated in abdominal cavity. That means inside the female body, inside the female body. Okay, so what happens? This ovary, they release ovum or egg. Okay, as in case of testes, testes release sperms. Okay, but we have some difference. Okay, because testes produce sperm anytime. Okay, it's not fixed that it will produce at a certain time only. Whereas ovaries produce sperm only once in 4 weeks, that means only in a month. That means these produce one mature ovum every 4 weeks. That means it produce one okay, I will write here only. It produces one egg. It produces one mature egg, and that only in 4 weeks. That only in 4 weeks. Okay, that means it takes time. To eggs to be mature takes time. Okay, so each in every 4 weeks, almost 1 month, only one egg is produced. Only one egg is released. Only one egg is released. Second one, oviduct. Oviduct. Okay, so it is also called fallopian tube. It is also called fallopian tube. Also called, it is also called fallopian tube. So what is the function of fallopian tube or oviduct? Same as in case of vas deferens. Vas deferens was a duct. Okay, that means sperm duct. So fallopian tube is also a duct. That means it is a passage. It is a passage. Okay, so it is a thin and cold muscular tube which joins the uterus and ovary. It is a muscular tube which joins ovaries and ovary and uterus. Which joins ovary and uterus, sorry. Uterus. Okay. So in the case of vas deferens, okay, in the case of vas deferens, the sperm duct, they join testes and urethra. Okay. Same oviduct joins, is a muscular tube which joins ovary with uterus. Ovary with uterus. It is a tube-like structure, okay, from where egg is released, from where egg is released, okay. Then third one we have uterus. Third one we have uterus. Okay, so when egg is produced from the ovaries, when egg is produced from the ovaries, what happens? There is one mature egg. Okay, there is one mature egg which is connected with oviduct to the uterus and ovary. When it releases egg, it releases through the oviduct. Okay, a tube-like structure, fallopian tube-like, a tube-like structure. Okay, which passes through the ova. Okay, which passes through the ova and reaches the uterus. So egg must be released in uterus. Okay, so uterus, it is a broader muscular chamber that receives ovum. Okay, it is a muscular chamber which receive ovum or egg. Okay, for formation of zygote, for formation of fetus. Okay, that means it contains developing fetus. It contains developing fetus that we will learn when we discuss about fertilization in humans. Okay, so uterus is a muscular chamber which receives ovum or egg from the ovaries through oviduct. Okay. So we can say it is a muscular chamber which receives ovum or egg from the ovaries through oviduct. Then last one is vagina. Last is vagina. Okay. So vagina, the uterus opens into a wide muscular tube. So uterus opens in a wide muscular tube. It is a wide muscular tube. It is also a muscular chamber. It is a chamber. That means uterus is a chamber. That means it has a space where development of fetus takes place. Okay. But vagina is a wide muscular tube. It is also wide, but it is tube-like structure. It is a tube-like structure. Okay. It is a muscular tube. So, the function of different things. Ovary function is to produce egg. Oviduct function is to transport the egg in the uterus. Okay. Uterus, its function is to receive the sperm from the penis. Okay. To receive the sperm from the penis, and the development of fetus takes place in uterus. Vagina, it is a wide muscular tube. Okay, it is a wide muscular tube and it has an opening. It has an opening. Okay, and also it is used for urination. That means it is also used to deliver to pass urine. Also used to pass urine and receive sperm. Okay, as in case of penis function is to pass urine and release sperm, whereas vagina function is to pass urine and receive sperm during mating. Okay, it receives the sperm and it is sent to uterus, where there is an ovum or egg, a mature ovum and egg. And when it is fertilized, we call it a zygote. We call it a zygote. Okay. And the maturity, this egg, as we talked about testes, that sperm is produced when a male, that means when a boy reaches a sexual maturity. That was about 12 to 14 years. 12 to 14 years. To produce a sperm, a male body must acquire 14 to 15 years. Whereas to release the egg, the female body must attain the age of 11 to 12 years. 11 to 12 years. So we can say that female becomes mature at an early stage. That means before male. Okay. So this was all about male reproductive system and female reproductive system. So, okay, we will again have a comparison. We will have a comparison between these two. Okay, these two means between male and female reproductive system. So, in male reproductive system also, four parts are involved. Female reproductive system also, four parts are involved. Okay. Testes, vas deferens, urethra and penis. Okay. Where testes is a oval structure which produce sperm when a organism, in case of humans, attain the age of 14 to 15 years. Okay. These testes release what? Sperm, and sent to urethra through vas deferens. It is a sperm duct. In urethra, we have a seminal vesicle which releases a fluid, okay, which releases a fluid to give nourishment to the sperm. And the combination of the fluid and the sperm is known as semen. Okay. At last, that semen, it is released through the penis. Okay, it is released through the penis during mating. Okay, and penis has a erectile muscle tissue, a muscular tissue, and have a number of blood capillaries, okay, a blood vessel which helps in its erectile function. Okay, so this was all about males. Similar is the case with female, but here we have another thing. We have ovaries which produce egg once, only one egg, only 1 week in 4 weeks. Okay, it is situated in abdominal cavity, that means it is situated inside the female body, whereas testis is situated outside the body. Okay, we have an oviduct which is also called fallopian tube, okay, same as vas deferens. And if a woman, okay, doesn't need a child, so there must be a blockage in this fallopian tube. If there is a blockage in this fallopian tube, there will be no development of a baby, that means there will be no baby. Okay, that can be of different types. That means if ovary is not produced, or sorry, if egg is not produced by the ovaries, if fallopian tube is blocked, okay, then we have uterus which is connected through ovaries by a oviduct, okay, which is connected by ovaries through oviduct, okay, it is a tube like structure. And uterus is a muscular chamber which receive ovum, which receive ovum from the ovaries, okay, and it is quite broad, okay, where development of a baby can take place. It is a muscular chamber. Okay, at last we have vagina. It is a wide muscular tube, that means after uterus we have a wide muscular tube, and its function is to pass urine as well as receive the sperm from the penis. Okay, that means male reproductive system. When penis, when sperm is released through the penis, vagina, it received and it sends to the uterus where there is already an ovum or egg, and when sperm fertilized with this egg in the uterus, fetus or development of fetus takes place. So this all system we will talk it in, what you can say, fertilization in human beings. So these are all the only the structure or parts of male and female reproductive system. Structure of parts of male and female reproductive system. Okay, and same thing. Okay, if there is a problem, or if that person doesn't require a baby, okay, either his vas deferens is cut off through surgeries, or there might be a problem in the quality of the sperm. Okay, here also same thing. If an female body, okay, is unable to give birth to a baby, okay, so there must be that, it can say that, we can say that the egg is not produced by the ovaries, okay, or the fallopian tube or the oviduct is either blocked, okay, is either blocked or is not lubricated. Okay, so this was all about male and female reproductive system. Both the things are same, but only the term and the function is different. Okay, we can name it ovaries and testes, they produce gametes, male and female gametes. Oviduct and vas deferens, they are duct, that means which are joined with testes, ovaries, with uterus and uterus. Okay, urethra, okay, it receive the fluids through seminal vesicle which is mixed with sperm. Here in uterus, the egg receive the sperm and development of a baby, a zygote is takes place in uterus. Okay, and we have a organ like penis and vagina for transfer of sperms. Okay, for transfer of sperms. So this was all about male and female reproductive system.